Being beautiful, gorgeous, amazing, and talented.
She's just trying to seek Insta fame, you know, through social media, trying to go viral.
Talent!
I'm live 24/7. One night, I fell asleep during my live stream. My dad decided that it would be a good idea to yell at my sister, completely stealing my spotlight.
Thank God, I'd rather have your dad as a YouTuber than you. Hello guys, and welcome to my new series on this channel, Broad Spectrum, where I look into a variety of people and put them in a categorized category of either nonsensical people or sensical people. It's literally that blatant, so enjoy the video.
When I tell you to do something, I'm still the boss of you, am I not?
I literally woke up and people were just making fun of me.
I called Maya, yelling at her to take this video down. I was extremely hot. I was coming unglued. She called the police and live streamed that 911 call.
I can't believe people like this actually exist, where they make the media be their entire life and the only sentient reason why they exist. I feel like this happened ever since the Kim Kardashians. In words as bitch's intermuscular part of her leg, she stood up missing four quarters of her leg and talking about talent. The only talent she has is that her fucking leg is skinnier than my pinky. It's actually quite disgusting that you can see her bones popping out of her leg. If someone ever came up to me and said they could beat me in a fight, I would like for them to have some kind of evidence of it. It's the same thing with this dumb broad. No fucking female in the pop culture right now has talent. I mean, just to X out a few, look at Kim Kardashian. There's no fucking talent in that woman at all. Look at Daniel Broccoli. Where the fuck is her talent?
I'm like seriously in fear for my life. He's threatening to kill me, he's threatening all this stuff, and it's like, I'm
shut up, bitch. I know you guys see that fucking parrot resemblance. It's like God sent me on this mission to find the rogue parrot and put it back in its cage.
I'm really scared.
I noticed that she was still live streaming from the hotel room that she went to that evening. She eventually did get on the phone with me.
She literally screen recorded her fucking dad calling her. How insecure can you be about yourself to want to carry something out at this caliber for any longer than it has already been?
You are a narcissistic drama queen, okay? You are.
For lack of better words, yes, I'm going to have to agree with your dad on that.
My dad was just totally lying about me to embarrass me. He even said I was dead to him.
That's really the nicest thing that your dad could possibly ever say to you in that particular scenario. He should have said, really, he should have said this, I never should have had you, or I wish you were born in the Doom universe so you could get ripped in half into itty bitty pieces. If this bitch doesn't think she's in a wrong, there is something in her fucking head that has been knocked clean off, possibly the hippocampus or the entirety of the limbic system.
I wish you the best, goodbye, you're dead to me.
And I meant it then and I mean it now.
Now I know a lot of drama queens are going to say, you should never say that to your daughter. He's generous for even taking care of her for like, what, 20 years now or something? In that case, I would have fucking aborted her the moment she started showing symptoms of whatever the fuck it is. Now I'm not going to sit here and say, oh, this has nothing to do with her upbringing at all. No, her upbringing probably plays a big part into this, or at least is like dominoes to what is really wrong with her. And honestly, I recommend a psychiatrist or a psychologist to figure out if this woman has the cognitive ability of an average person, or if she's even mentally fit as a person.
Till this day, I have not contacted my dad whatsoever. He's just a jealous hater.
Maya's all about trying to be Insta-famous.
My biggest fear is that my dad's going to use this narrative to make me look like a liar.
Help me out here, guys. I don't know if I'm missing all my brain cells or something, but did she not make fun of a woman with cancer? And even if the woman didn't have cancer, that doesn't make it better or any better to make fun of somebody that could possibly have cancer. Just because I know if this dumb bitch watches this video, she won't understand what I'm saying. Not even the most simplest analogy would ring anything together in her brain. So I'll just say this. Imagine you are talking to a fat person. You call them morbidly obese, but they're not even morbidly obese. And I've never been very close to being morbidly obese. But they look like they could be morbidly obese. The point of that very simple-minded analogy is that even if they didn't have this disease and they somehow look like they do have this disease, or cancer in particular in this case, that doesn't make it right for you to make fun of them. Use your fucking brain.
One day, or seeing my thing being famous and
what the fuck did she just say? If she has a single bit of fans, I can almost bet my soul on the fact that 99.9% of her fucking fans are either exactly like her, or they're a bunch of simps for skinny leg, benevolent women that never take showers.
I decided to just troll.
How pathetic can you be
You're fat, you're ugly, you look deformed.
I saw this girl with the ugliest hairline.
It is a wig. Oh my god, that's embarrassing. Leukemia? Do you have cancer? Oh my god, do you have cancer?
And I was like, oh, you know, messed up hairline, wig, and oh, wig, cancer, you know? I just connected the dots. She wasn't actually wearing a wig.
You are such a loser. You're wearing a wig because you're bald, huh?
I thought everything I said was funny. I thought it was hilarious.
I'll literally take all your cancer money. I'm going to see you for all your wigs and chemo.
Despite what you jealous haters think, like, I have morals. I would never attack anybody who's like a minor, visibly disabled.
You should probably keep looking in the mirror.
I knew she didn't have cancer. The video got reposted. People were saying things like, you're gonna find me, kill me. These cancer patients wanted an apology, so I gave them a apology.
I am sorry, yes. I'm apologizing because, like, I really feel bad.
She's either sweating because of how under pressure she is, or she has PTSD, which I'm going to go with the first one. You know what would be really, 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 really funny? Is if she woke up one Saturday day and realized that her lips were gone. So then that would mean no more, oh my god, oh my god, this girl has cancer. Like, bro, get the fuck out of my way.
I feel like it was a pretty good apology. I really want Dr. Phil to clear my name because I really didn't do anything.
You got a lot of attention for a video that you didn't want to go out, but it went out, right?
No, that's not true.
What happened?
So what happened was I was just being famous, and one of my viewers reposted the clip.
What do you mean you were just being famous? How do you be famous?
I guess being like gorgeous, beautiful, amazing, talented, and just a celebrity, you know?
So you're gorgeous,
beautiful, amazing, and
amazing, talented, and a celebrity?
Yeah. And you know what? Like, I can't just not be gorgeous, so I just don't really care, you know?
And how do you define famous?
Me. I knew I was born famous, a superstar.
Mm-hmm. And...
what the fuck am I asking, machine? Motherfucker, where's my ass machine?
No, but no, hold on.
This bitch is making me laugh. I'm sorry.
Hey, what's wrong with my voice? I'm sorry, Dr. Phil, hold up.
Seriously.
Give me a fucking minute, dog!
I'm trying to...
I got my head out the sunroof. I'm blasting my favorite tunes. I only got one thing on my mind. You got me stuck on the thought of you. You're making me feel brand new. You're more than a sunshine in my eyes. You got those pretty eyes in your head. You know it. You got me dancing in my bed, so let me show it. You are exactly what I want. Kinda cool and kinda not. Wanna give myself to you. Yeah, we're driving down the freeway at night. I only got one thing in the back of my mind. I'm feeling like this might be my time to shine with you.